good morning. Welcome to Victory Baptist Church this morning. Let's all get a songbook, stand and turn to page 135. Page 135.
Joy it is to be in the Lord's house. Certainly good to see all of you here today. And we welcome each and every one of you today to Victory Baptist Church. Welcome those who are listening by way of radio, those who are watching by live stream. And we certainly appreciate you tuning our way today. Looking forward to what God's going to do on this first Sunday of the month of June. Amen. And I've been thankful for what God has already done already this year. Looking forward to what God's going to do today and throughout the other weeks that are coming up, amen, and us trusting God to meet with us as we gather here today. And as we pray, let's do pray for the service. Let's remember those today that are lost, that God would deal with their hearts. Also, continue to pray for our troops and also our missionaries, remembering them and their families in prayer today. Also, continue to pray for Kenley Edwards, Mike and Holly Hazelton. Continue to pray for them. Also, Mike Verzall, Jamie Steinbeck, Jimmy Murray, Wade West. Also want you to know we appreciate you praying for my wife. She had her eye surgery this past week. Everything went good. We're thankful for that. And so we appreciate your prayers. Also, David Morgan. Also, Eddie Dominic. Dwayne Combs. Brother Combs had some more skin cancer surgery this week. And Sister Judy called me last night and said he was having a tough time with it, where they operated on his forehead there. And so pray for Brother Combs. Also, Brother Jimmy Jones, remember him, remember his family. Janice Hart Watson, Chloe Rochester, Woody Brooks, Judy Pryor, Sharon Dickerson, David Gill, Kevin Roach, Kathy Curran, Cheryl McAlpin, and Tiffany Parker. Also, let's continue to pray for Marvin Robertson, John Matthews, James and Beulah Edwards, Pat Matthews, Sarah Gupton, and Ellen Thompson praying for these today. And I'm sure that you have burdens and needs on your heart as well. That there are things that we all carry in our heart for folks that are in need. And so we certainly want to pray for them today. Amen. That God would help all of us as we pray for each other. And especially let's remember those that are lost, that God will deal with their hearts. And pray for our country, pray for our county, amen. Pray for all the men of God this morning as they stand to preach, that God will anoint them, God will use them, amen. Many souls will be saved throughout our area, and we're thankful for what God's doing, amen. And so pray for the choir this morning, special singing, and all that's said and done, that the Lord would be glorified through it all, amen. And so let's bow for prayer. How many glad you're here? Amen. That's good. I'm glad you're here. I'm glad we're able to be here this morning. And thank God I'm glad he's here. Amen. Most of all. And so let's do pray. I'm going to ask Brother Ray Branch, if he will, to come pray for us this morning. And as he leads us to the Lord in prayer, let's just all pray together and trust that God will meet with us this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. God's good, isn't he? And I sure appreciate his goodness and mercy.
Our Father in heaven, we thank you all for your grace, your mercy. Thank you that through the blood of Christ we can be saved if we only confess and ask. Ask you to bless the preacher as he preaches. God, give him liberty and power and fullness of the Spirit and lead him in the way that you have him to go, and give us ears to hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. For it's in Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you.
thankful for the day the Lord saved me. Amen. I believe if they'd have sung that chorus one more time, some of y'all might have got glad. Amen. Or to be glad. Hallelujah. For what the Lord's done in our lives. Certainly good to see you here this morning. And thank God for what he's already done in our hearts today. Amen. While the ushers are coming to receive our morning offering as we worship through our giving, I'm going to make mention of a couple of things. Of course, next Sunday morning, Living in Victory will be doing the last Arise fundraiser, starting at 9 o'clock next Sunday morning. If you'd like to have donut and coffee, they'll be out in the fellowship hall for that, and just $5 per person, just to try to help raise a little money for Arise coming up in just a little over a month away. And if you can help out with that, that would be a blessing, amen? And we appreciate if you can do that. And then, of course, a week from tomorrow is our Vacation Bible School, June the 12th through the 14th. And we're certainly looking forward to Bible school that week. And 7 o'clock each night till 9 o'clock. And we would love to have all the young people we possibly can to be with us during those 3 nights of Bible school. And so I want to encourage all the young people, please invite some of your friends and get them to come, amen, and be with you during Bible school. And then, of course, don't forget we have the Battle of the Buckets. And that's always exciting, amen. And who won last year? Boys did, right? Boys won. Hallelujah. So we need to repeat. We need to repeat on that. Amen. And I forgot what my wife had to do. I don't even remember what. It wasn't good, whatever it was. So we'll do something. It'll be fun. I know that. And we'll have a good time of Bible school that week. So just in this week, you've got 1 week from tomorrow to be able to invite your friends, get them to come with you, and be with us for Bible school. And then 2 weeks from today is Father's Day, and then 3 weeks from today is homecoming with Ricky Atkinson. And so looking forward to a great, fun-filled month of June, amen, around Victory Baptist Church. And so I hope you'll make plans to be here in each and everything that will be coming up during those days, amen. And so let's bow for prayer and just trust God to meet with us today. Brother Gary, how about praying for us this morning? Amen.
Let's pray. Father, as we come to you today, Lord, would you just be with each and every one of us here today, Lord. And as the preacher brings the word today, Lord, let's let it apply to our hearts, Lord. And Lord, all the people's lost and undone, Lord, just touch their hearts. Everybody listen to my radio and Facebook, Lord, just touch them. And Lord, as we take this offering, Lord, just uplift your kingdom, Lord, is your name. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Appreciate that this morning. All right, we're going to get the Finch family to come. Let's see. All right. Appreciate these that are coming to sing. Brother Chris is going to play for them this morning, so you pray for them, amen, as they sing. Amen.
Thank you.
Amen. Well, let's all stand. Turn around, shake your neighbor's hand. Let them know you're glad to see them this morning while Children's Church is dismissed today. Amen. Amen, brother. Good.
Strange chord progressions.
I bet so. Amen. Hallelujah. Appreciate that singing. Amen. That was good. I like that. I like what they're singing about. Amen. If you have your Bible this morning, I want you to turn with us to the book of Leviticus, chapter number 17. Leviticus chapter number 17 this morning. And I want to read one verse, verse number 11. Leviticus chapter 17 and verse number 11. The Bible says, for the life of the flesh is in the blood. And I have given it to you upon the altar to make an atonement for your souls. For it is the blood that maketh an atonement for your soul. I want to read it again. For the life of the flesh is in the blood. And I have given it to you upon the altar to make an atonement for your souls. For it is the blood that maketh an atonement for the soul. Our Heavenly Father, we're grateful again for the privilege that we've had to be here already today in the house of God. Thank you, Father, for all that you have done. Thank you, Lord, for the word that we have heard this morning from Sunday school. God, thank you for the songs. Thank you, Father, for the fellowship. Thank you, Father, for helping us, Lord, already today. God, I pray now just for a little while that you might help me, dear God, as I stand to open your word. And Lord, by the help of God, by the anointing of the Holy Ghost, to be able to preach the word, dear Lord, as you would have us to preach it this morning. God, that each of us in this building and those who are watching and listening, that God, we would give our devoted attention to what thus saith the word of God. Father, especially I pray if there's anybody lost, I pray today would be the day that they would be saved. God, that today will be the day we can rejoice in that which you have done in our lives as the people of God. Thank you again, God, for Victory Baptist Church and every family and home, every individual. And I pray you'll bless, Lord, each one today. And Lord, again, touch all the many that are sick. God, bless them, help them. And Father, all that's done, we'll give you praise and glory, for we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. I want to preach this morning from this verse on the thought, the blood of Jesus. As I think about the blood of Jesus today, and I want you to realize, as here we've read in this verse, that God said he has given you the blood for the atonement for your souls. For he said it is the blood. It is the blood that maketh an atonement for the soul. There is no atonement for the soul outside of the blood. And specifically today, no atonement for the soul outside the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus that pumped through the body of Christ is what keeps Christianity alive. Blood, I've heard this when I first got saved, blood flows through the Bible. And if you could cut it anywhere, and it will bleed, amen? The blood is spoken of 427 times in the Word of God, showing us that it is not a minor thing. Without the blood, the gospel is dead. And you and I this morning would be deprived of eternal life. Jesus said, "For this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many for the remission of sins." Paul said, "Without the shedding of blood, there is no remission." And also the Bible said in Colossians 1:14, we have redemption through the blood, even the forgiveness of sins. And Peter said that we are not redeemed with silver and gold and precious stones, but we are redeemed with the precious blood of Christ. And then John agreed with Peter and with Paul when he wrote in 1 John chapter 1 and verse number 7, when he said, "The blood of Jesus Christ cleanseth us from all sin." Now, beloved, this morning it is the blood of Jesus that sets a person free from their sin, amen? The early church understood the blood, then the importance of the blood. In the 22 sermons that were recorded by the four preachers in the book of Acts, they all give the same message, the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Jesus. They understood that his death and the provision of the covering of the blood was essential to the gospel of Christ. Amen? Can you see this morning, as we look at the blood of Jesus, how important that the blood is? The Bible paints a broad stroke about the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen? And the blood of Jesus is so important that the Bible gives us detail about his blood. All of us this morning, thank God for the blood that is flowing through your body at this very moment. While you have been in church this morning, your heart has been beating. And every time your heart beats, it's pumping that blood throughout your entire body. Amen? And if it wasn't for your heart pumping that blood, and that blood is what is carrying in life to all of the members of your body. This morning, the blood of Jesus is the only life-giving force to a person that is dead in trespasses and in sins. It is the blood of Jesus that must be applied to a sinner's heart in order for them to be saved and to be alive in Jesus Christ. As we think about the blood this morning, I want you to notice a few things quickly. First of all, in analysis, the blood of Jesus is perfect. The virgin birth of Christ established his righteousness. Judas made this statement. He said, "I have betrayed innocent blood." Paul said it like this, "For he hath made him to be sin for us, who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him." Amen. Pilate even said, "I find no fault at all in him." Amen. Jesus himself asked, "Which of you convinceth me of sin?" There was not a person alive that had lived around Jesus Christ that could ever charge him with anything that he had ever done wrong, because he had never done anything wrong, because he is and was and always will be the perfect Son of God. And the reason being is because the blood is perfect. Amen? Oh, listen, the Bible also tells us that he is spoken of as holy and harmless, undefiled and separate from sinners. The Bible said, "Who did no sin, neither was guile found in his mouth." And so John also added in 1 John 3:5, "In him is no sin. What made the difference between Jesus and every other person ever born? It was his blood. His blood was perfect, amen? A natural father, Brother Rick touched on this morning Sunday school, a natural father would have imparted the sin nature of Adam to Christ, and his death would not have provided redemption for the world, amen? But the virgin birth is absolutely essential to the salvation of sinners. And the Bible clearly teaches us that Jesus was virgin born. He did not have original sin. Amen. Matthew quotes Isaiah in Matthew chapter 1 and verse 23. He said, "Behold, a virgin shall be with child and shall bring forth the son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel," which being interpreted is God with us. Jeremiah the prophet had spoken years before about this. He said in Jeremiah 31 and verse 22, "The Lord hath created a new thing upon the earth. A woman shall compass a man." Hallelujah. And it was certainly something new for a woman to have a child without ever knowing a man. Amen. But that's exactly what happened. I'm glad Jesus had no earthly father. He only had a heavenly father, amen. And he imparted unto Mary, that virgin, the perfect seed of God. And therefore, when Jesus was born, he was born perfectly with a perfect body in perfect blood that was running through his veins. And therefore, he was without sin. Therefore, his blood was perfect. And that's important. Amen. I got news for you. My blood nor your blood is perfect. Every time I go to the doctor, they always find something wrong with me. And you know how they find it? They take blood. They got a vampire down there at our doctor's office. Got a big needle. Amen. Comes in there about four or five tubes and empties it all out. But they look at everything. The analysis of the blood tells what's wrong with you. And guess what? There's always something wrong with you. There's always something wrong with me. Amen? But Jesus, had they done a blood test on him, they would have found nothing wrong with him. His blood was perfect. He was the perfect Son of God. Amen? Oh, the nature of man was not imputed and imparted unto Jesus when he was born because he did not have that Adamic natured filled blood coursing through his veins, but he had the very perfect blood of God. Amen? So in analysis, the blood is perfect. But notice, secondly, in application, the blood is pure. The blood is pure. Now, one of the reasons that when we have communion, that we use grape juice in our communion service and not wine is because wine has to go through a process of fermentation. The process of fermentation is actually bacteria that is working in the juice. It is a rotting process, if you will, and it is a picture of sin. And so this could never give a pure picture of the precious blood of Jesus, amen, using wine, amen. And may I say that the devil always has a counterfeit for everything that God always does, amen. He's always trying to counterfeit it. And so pure grape juice is the symbol of the pure blood of the Lord Jesus, just as the bread is to be without leaven to show the pureness of the body of Christ. Amen. And so the writer tells us that in the book of Hebrews, he tells us about the blood. Now, we know that when people are going through certain types of cancer, there's a process through that they can do kind of like a dialysis. And what they do, they take the blood out of you and they pump it into a machine, and the machine takes out all the bacteria, and then the pure blood is pumped back in to your body. And they use that in certain types of cancer. And after the blood has been purged of the germs and the disease and the bad cells, then it's able to work against the enemy cells that are within your body. May I say this morning, thank God for the pure blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. The Bible tells us in Hebrews chapter number 9, for if the blood of bulls and of goats and the ashes of an heifer sprinkling the unclean sanctifieth the purifying of the flesh, how much more shall the blood of Jesus, amen. If God could take that blood from bulls and goats, he could take that blood that had impurities and it could cover sin for a little while. How much more then shall the blood of Jesus, hallelujah. Thank God who through the eternal spirit offered himself without spot to God. Purge your conscience from dead works to serve the living God. Amen. And when the pure blood of the Savior is applied to the sinner, it becomes a cleansing agent. Praise God. I'm glad this morning our sins are removed only through the blood of Jesus Christ. There was no other way that we could be separated from our sins. There was no other way to get our sins forgiven other than through the blood, amen, of Jesus Christ. Oh, when the pure blood of the Savior is applied to the sinner, it provides a cleansing, amen. John said the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanseth us from all sin. I still love the song that says, what can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Peter said, for as much as you know, you were not redeemed with corruptible things as silver and gold. Amen? But with the precious blood of Christ, as of a lamb without spot and without blemish. Amen. Oh, thank God this morning for the blood of Jesus. In analysis, his blood is perfect. In application, his blood is pure. But in action, his blood is perpetual. Now, in the Old Testament, the animal sacrifices were continuous. Year after year after year after year. And they always had to bring a blood sacrifice. The blood of bulls and of goats provided forgiveness and pardon only temporarily, because all of those sacrifices pointed to the ultimate sacrifice, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And in Hebrews chapter 7, verse 27, he talks about Christ. He said, who needeth not daily as those high priests to offer up sacrifices, first for his own sins and then for the people's, for this he did once when he offered up himself. The blood of Jesus is perpetual. In other words, he only had to shed his blood one time. Amen. He didn't have to die over and over and over again. He died one time. This he did once, amen, when he offered up himself. Paul says it was not by the blood of goats and calves, but by his own blood. He entered in once into the holy place, having obtained eternal redemption for us in Hebrews 9:12. In Hebrews 9:26, he says, but now once, in the end of the world hath he appeared to put away sin by the sacrifice of himself. Amen. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 10 and verse number 12, but this man, talking about Jesus, after he had offered one sacrifice for sins forever. Hallelujah. He offered one sacrifice for sins forever. And after he offered himself, and that himself was the sacrifice, his blood was the blood that was shed. And when he had offered one sacrifice for sins forever, he sat down on the right hand of God. Hallelujah. Amen. You see, the death of Christ set into motion a continuous cleansing for those who trust him. I got saved 44 years ago, Brother Mark, but the blood of Jesus, there's a continual cleansing in my life. Hallelujah. Woo! Well, if that don't make you want to run back to town and back. Amen. He did it once. He only had to do it one time. Amen. And there's a continual cleansing. And we are given the gift of eternal life based upon that one sacrifice forever. That one sacrifice. He sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. And we who have trusted him and who have been saved, born into the family of God, the blood of Jesus Christ cleanseth us, amen, from all sin. Hallelujah. Oh, thank God we have the gift of eternal life through the life that he purchased with his blood. Amen. And when we're saved, we're saved. Amen. We're saved. The Bible speaks of the blood of the everlasting covenant. In Hebrews chapter 13 and verse number 20. And our faith in his blood is all that it takes to settle our account forever. Amen. Thank God for the blood of Jesus. Well, I know there's a lot of people that think the blood is obsolete. There's people that do not believe in the blood. They don't want to hear you preaching about the blood. They don't even sing about the blood anymore. But without the blood, there is no remission. Amen. In analysis, the blood is perfect. In application, the blood is pure. In action, the blood is perpetual. But here's what I rejoice in. In accomplishment, the blood is powerful. Amen. The songwriter said it like this. Would you be free from the burden of sin? That's a question. There's power in the blood. Would you over evil a victory win? That's a question. The answer, there's wonderful power in the blood. There is power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Amen. And so I'm glad this morning the blood, the accomplishment of the blood, it's powerful. Powerful this morning. John wrote in Revelation chapter 5 and verse number 9, he said, thou hast redeemed us to God by thy blood. His blood. It takes amazing power to do that. Amen. We are told in Revelation chapter 12 that they overcame the wicked one by the blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. I'm glad there's power in the blood. False religion has denied the blood. They've always denied the blood, and they have denied its power. Mary Baker Eddy of the Christian Science Movement said this, the material blood of Jesus is no more efficacious to cleanse from sin when it was shed upon the cursed tree than when it was flowing through his veins. See, in other words, she said, the blood doesn't mean nothing. But I got news for you. The blood means everything. Amen. The blood means everything. Another Bible teacher, if you can call him that, said the red liquid that ran through the veins and arteries of Jesus' mortal body is not related to our salvation. How in the world can you be saved without the blood? When God said, I have given you the blood, amen, it is the blood that maketh atonement for your soul. It is the blood, thank God, of the Lord Jesus Christ. It's only through the blood can you be forgiven, amen. Of course, these teachers, like many others, they stand in complete opposition to the word of God that declares without the shedding of blood, there is no remission, amen. Oh, it's the blood. Thank God the blood is powerful. I'm glad there's wonder-working power in the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm glad there's power, thank God, to cleanse every sinner that will come to him and trust him as their Savior. I'm glad his precious blood is still powerful enough to cleanse whosoever will. Amen. Then I want to say also in acquittal, his blood is permanent. Amen. I read this joke the other day. It said a woman went to get her picture made at a photography studio, and she told the photographer, she said, do me justice. The photographer said, ma'am, you don't need justice, you need mercy. I don't know about y'all, I don't want justice. I needed mercy. I'm glad I fell broken upon the altar of repentance and the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Thank God cleansed me, amen. I'm glad this blood this morning, thank God, the blood is permanent in its acquittal. Acquit, it means to pay off. It means to free. It means to clear. It means to absolve. Oh, it has far-reaching meaning extending from the past all the way into the future. You and I this morning, we know we're guilty. We know we're sinners. Amen. We're reminded of it every day as we live our lives. But I'm so thankful, thank God, since the day that I gave my heart to Jesus Christ. I'm glad the blood of Jesus, thank God, has been permanent in my life. Amen. I'm glad I've been acquitted. I'm glad I've been pardoned. I'm glad I've been set free, thank God, because of the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. It is the blood that maketh atonement. Amen. It's the blood. And we, you and I needed something that was permanent. And the blood is permanent. Amen. I'm glad the Bible said that Jesus' blood cleanses us from our sins. This morning when you got saved, Jesus' blood washed all your sins away. Amen. They're gone. I'm sure there are people that see you a lot and they remember you back when, before you got saved. They remember that. They could probably tell us a lot of good stories about your life. But aren't you glad God's blood has forgiven you and cleansed you from all of those sins? Amen. Isaiah said it like this in Isaiah 44, 22. I have blotted out as a thick cloud thy transgressions and as a cloud thy sins. Return unto me, for I have redeemed thee. Amen. And of course, we know David said in Psalm 103, verse 12, as far as the east is removed from the west, so far hath he removed our transgressions from us. Amen. I'm glad he has promised to never remember them against us ever again. They're gone. Amen. Thank God for the precious blood. The blood cleanses. I'm glad the blood covers. Amen. The blood covers, amen, our sins at the very moment, both sins of omission and commission. I'm glad, praise God, for the blood of Jesus that continually cleanses our lives, amen. And I'm glad it continues on in the future. Praise God. That's the reason I don't have to go back to Calvary and get saved again. He cleansed me and he cleanseth. The word cleanseth. The blood of Jesus Christ cleanseth us. That word cleanseth means an ongoing process. Amen. I'm glad we're saved. I got saved that Friday night by the power of the blood of Jesus Christ that was applied to my heart. And ever since that Friday night, all through these years, the blood of Jesus Christ. Praise God. Every time God looks at me, all he can see is the blood of his dear son. All that God knows about me, that I've been washed in the blood. When he looks at me, he don't see me. He sees the blood. Hallelujah. I'm this morning for the power of the blood of Jesus Christ that is able to save whosoever will. Amen. The blood, thank God, is permanent. Amen. It cleanseth us from all sin. And then in appraisal, the blood is precious. The Bible tells us that it's precious. We sing, oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Peter used that term precious when he described the blood of Christ. He said, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of a lamb without blemish and without spot. Oh, can you imagine as they brought those little lambs? I mean, it would be hard for me to kill a little lamb. But they had to bring those lambs. As they brought those lambs were killed. Their blood was shed. Their blood was sprinkled to cover their sin. But Peter said, when he looked at Jesus, but with the precious blood of the Lamb. His blood is precious when you begin the appraisal of it. I read a story about a wealthy old man, and he had an elaborate collection of very valuable paintings. He had Van Gogh's and Monet paintings and others. And his only son shared the father's interest in the rare paintings. And they traveled around the world buying up these paintings wherever they could find them. The son later enlisted in the army, was placed in the medical corps. In a severe battle while carrying a wounded soldier to safety, the son was seriously injured and he died. The mother was dead already, and the news of the tragedy of the death of his only son devastated the old father. He grieved in loneliness for months. And one day a knock came at his door, and when he opened the door, he found a young man with a package standing there, and the young man explained that he was one of the several soldiers that his son had carried out to safety. And knowing his interest in paintings, he had painted a picture of the old man's son and presented it to the father. The painting was not rare. The painting was not valuable, since the artist that had painted it was not anyone special. But the painting became very precious to the old dad, because it was a resemblance of his son. The man moved a very valuable painting from the mantle, and he placed the picture of his son in its place. Hour after hour, he would sit in his rocking chair and just stare up at that picture of his son. When death came, the art collection was put up for sale by auction. Hundreds of collectors came from everywhere to bid on all of these paintings. The auctioneer announced that stated that the picture of his son was to be auctioned first. And then a moan of disappointment went through the crowd, and people could say, "Let's get on with the real paintings. Bring out the real paintings. We want the real stuff." The son's picture was held up as the auctioneer began. And he cried, "Who will give 100? Who will give 100? Who will give 100? Who will give 50? Who will give 50? Who will give 50? Who will give 25? Who will give 25? Finally, a kind old gentleman in the back said, "I'll give $10 for it." And so it was sold to that man for $10. At the end, when he said, "Sold," the man said, "The auction is now over." The auction is now over. This concludes the auction. The crowd was puzzled. They couldn't believe it. And then the statement was given by the clerk. The will declared of the old man that the son's picture was to be sold, and the person who bought it would get the entire collection. Well, hallelujah. The old man that paid $10 for the picture of the son was suddenly amazed at the fact that he now owned all of those valuable paintings. In other words, when a person takes the son, everything God has is included with it. Amen. I don't know about y'all this morning, but I'm glad I got the son. Amen. I'm glad I got the son. I'm glad if you've got the son, thank God you've got all you need. Amen. If you've got the son, you've got all that you need for here and for eternity. If you've got the son, thank God you've got everything that God has included for his children. Aren't you glad this morning to be a child of God? Amen. Because of the son. Hey, you know what made it all possible? The blood, thank God, of Jesus Christ. And I close with this thought this morning. In aggression, the blood is protective. Exodus chapter 12, we find God making reference about the blood. He told the children of Israel, he said, "You take a lamb for a family. Make sure that lamb is perfect, pure, and you kill that lamb and catch that blood in a basin. And you bring that blood to your home, and you put the blood on the doorpost and the lintel of the door. And God said, when I pass over Egypt this night, when I see the blood, I'll pass over you. Woo! The blood is protective. Amen. Oh, the blood is protective. Now, I'm glad the blood, he said, shall be a token upon the houses where you are. When I see the blood, I will pass over you, and the plague shall not be upon you to destroy you when I smite the land of Egypt. We still speak of being under the blood. I'm glad because we're under the blood, the judgment will not fall on those who have placed their faith in the Lord Jesus Christ and have accepted him as their Savior. Thank God for the protection of the blood. Amen. Can you see Christ's blood this morning as he shed it on the cross of Calvary, even before he got to Calvary? The Bible said when he went to the Mount, before he went and went to the Mount of Olives, and while he was there in the Garden of Gethsemane, that he prayed until it was as his sweat became as great drops of blood falling down to the ground. They arrested him, took him in. I'm sure every time they smote him, Brother Ray, every time they hit him, there was blood. I can imagine he's bruised, he's bloody. Then they plait that crown of thorns, place it on his head, and the thorns goes in. Blood begins to run down his face. They take him out, and they tie him to the whipping post, and they whip him with the cat of nine tails, and they scourge him. And he's beaten beyond recognition, bleeding. Bleeding, his blood is being shed. Then they carry him to Calvary. He walks to Calvary. There they nailed him to the cross, lifted him up between heaven and earth, bleeding and dying for you and I. Thank God for the precious blood of Jesus. Matthew chapter 26, Jesus said it like this. Verse 26, and as they were eating, Jesus took bread, blessed it, broke it, and gave it to the disciples and said, take, eat, this is my body. Then he took the cup and he gave thanks and gave it to them, saying, drink ye all of it, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many for the remission of sins. Oh, Jesus shed his blood, willingly gave his life's blood that you and I could be saved by the grace of God. Oh, this morning there is power in the blood of Jesus. If you need help today, I can point you to the one who has power, wonder-working power in the blood of Jesus. Father, I thank you this morning for the precious blood of Christ. Thank you, Lord, for that blood that you willingly shed on the cross of Calvary, that through that blood we could have forgiveness of our sins. Oh, dear God in heaven, may people see today that there is power in the blood. There is power to set free from sin, power to break the chains of sin. There is power in the blood of Christ. God, I pray that you speak to hearts in this building, those who've been listening and watching. Pray, Father, for that one that's lost today, that they'll trust Jesus and his shed blood, that they too can know the forgiveness of sins. For we know that it is the blood that maketh atonement for the soul. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. While we stand this morning, they're going to sing. Thank God there's power in the blood of Jesus. Oh my. Just to think about it, I don't understand how it works, Brother Mark. I don't understand how a sinner can be washed in the red blood and come out pure and clean and white on the other side. All I know is that's what he did. He did go to Calvary. He did die. He did shed his blood. Thank God, and without the blood, there is no remission. But this morning, you can plead the blood over your soul and be saved today. While they sing, you mind the Lord this morning.
I was a sinner by my own admission. Oh. And I felt the weight of all my wrong decisions.
Oh my.
There was no way I could escape my sentence. But the cross declared a new conviction.
Rewriting all my destiny, restoring all my dignity. I'm rising in the victory of the blood of Jesus. My past lost in the mercy seat. I'm washed for all eternity.
Of the blood of Jesus.
Oh,
thank God for the blood. Are you washed in the blood? If not, I invite you to come this morning.
And no matter where my soul has ever wandered, I know the mercy of the judge is stronger. My case is closed and it won't be reopened.
Hallelujah.
Oh, for the power of the blood has spoken.
Rewriting all my destiny, restoring all my dignity. I'm rising in the victory of the blood of Jesus. My past lost in the mercy seat. I'm washed for all eternity. Now living in the legacy of the blood of Jesus.
Thank God for the blood.
I plead the blood of Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus.
Plead the blood of Jesus. Plead the blood.
I plead the blood of Jesus.
Rewriting all my destiny. Restoring all my dignity. I'm rising in the victory of the blood of Jesus. My past lost in the mercy seat. I'm washed for all eternity. Now living in the legacy of the blood of Jesus.
I'm glad that said that my case is closed. It won't be reopened. Whenever a person is acquitted by the law, no matter if they really did it or not, if they're acquitted, they can never be charged with it ever again. You and I this morning, we were guilty. We knew we were guilty. We know we deserved hell. We still deserve to go to hell. But praise God, because of the precious blood of Christ that has been applied. Thank God, even though we deserve to go to hell, we're not going to hell because we've been acquitted. We've been set free by the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Woo! I don't know about y'all, but I believe I can shout for a little while right now. Amen. What a precious, precious gift we have in the blood of Jesus. What a powerful, powerful gift we have in the blood of Jesus. And this morning I'm thankful that I know what that blood can do to a person's life because of what it did for my life when he saved me by his grace, washed me in his blood, cleansed me. Hallelujah. I want to get them to sing that last verse, and we're going to sing this last verse, and we're going to open the doors of the church. Maybe you feel like this is where God wants you to be a part of a Victory Baptist Church, be a member here. And we want to just open the doors of the church. If you haven't been baptized, we can baptize you. If you've been baptized and you're a member of another church, we can take care of all that. But if you feel like this is where God wants you, we want you here. And so they're going to sing one more verse, and this will be the end of it if nobody comes. But this is for, and if you're here today and you're not saved, we're not closing that invitation. There's always an open invitation for lost souls. From the time that front door is opened, there's an invitation. Whosoever will that want to come. But today, if you'd like to join our church, we'd love to have you if this is where God wants you. They're going to sing one more stanza of this. Praise God, just rejoice in the goodness of the Lord. Amen.
And no matter where my soul has ever wandered, I know the mercy of the judge is stronger. My case is closed and it won't be reopened. Oh, for the power of the blood has spoken.
Rewriting all my destiny, restoring all my dignity, I'm rising in the victory of the blood of Jesus. My past lost in the mercy seat, I'm washed for all eternity, now living in the legacy of the blood of Jesus.
I plead the blood of Jesus, plead the blood, I plead the blood of Jesus,
plead the blood, I plead the blood of Jesus, plead the blood, I plead the blood of Jesus. Restoring all my dignity, I'm rising in the victory of the blood of Jesus. My past lost in the mercy seat, I'm washed for all eternity, now living in the legacy of the blood of Jesus.
Oh, hallelujah. I praise the Lord. You can be seated, if you will, just for a moment. And I appreciate these this morning.